Comms. Communications. The functional glue that holds all modern military operations together. Also the bane of the existence of nearly every radio operator, data officer, or whatever they're calling military communication professionals these days. Many a soldier, sailor, airman, or marine has spent countless hours fine-tuning old radios, throwing copper wire up in the trees to get a signal, and readjusting the antenna for the 1,000th time to hit the exact right azimuth. Satellite communications are only slightly less headache-inducing. You pop out your antenna, you hook up your cables, you get the right aim point to your satellite, and boom, you're in business. Talking loud, talking clear. Well, most of the time. Other than satellite phones, which can't do all of the communications that troops need, SATCOM is still a little complicated. There are big dish antennas, sometimes specialized cable cuts and connectors. All of that means heavy gear, often carried in a vehicle. And while copper wire blends well with tree branches, a dish atop a building might stick out, painting a target where you've planted a communication node, meaning you're the target. Realizing it might need to improve its mobile communications suite in the near future, the Army recently held an evaluation of communications on the move, or OTM, and more specifically, at-the-quick, halt satellite communications, meaning move, stop, communicate, no big setups. To get a baseline for where they really need to go, in early June, soldiers with the 2nd Armored Brigade Combat Team, or the Spartans, out of 3rd Infantry Division, did a communications pilot at Fort Stewart, Georgia. They looked at beyond the line of sight communication. That basically means over the horizon and long distance, without the extra added service charges and fees. You know, for those of you born before, say, 2000, long distance charges, they were a thing. You had to pay extra if you want to call somebody outside. Forget it. They also worked with mesh network devices. A mesh network comm is basically creating a running network over the air that continually updates for the best signal and best frequency path, and also can transfer data packets and other information through kind of like internal retransmission from each of the radios that are connected to the network. That method helps avoid jamming and allow soldiers to run radios in tricky places like tunnel systems or dense urban areas. The Spartans, it's just fun to say out loud, also work with flat panel satellite terminal links. And that's a way users can avoid setting up massive dishes and associated gear. The tech also allows for a petite, by military standards, SATCOM equipment. Not part of that demo with the Spartans, but another interesting SATCOM development that Military Times recently spotted is coming from a company called Tamper Microwave. That company works with a larger Talos company, and they're both now working with Special Operations Command, or SOCOM, testing out suitcase-sized satellite communication systems that fold up and pop out and open about as easy as a laptop. That means more discreet SATCOM setup in crowded and always watching urban terrain. The gear, called Razer Scout, also features fewer components and a quicker setup. The new device shrinks the footprint down from 3 much larger pieces, think big dishes, into an all-in-one item. The company put this equipment together on its own, appealing to the trimmed-down nature of special operations and SOCOM missions. And Tamper Microwave is no garage tinkering operation. They already provide program of record satellite gear that they're trying to replace for SOCOM. Company officials told me that they began working with SOCOM testers who are evaluating prototypes of the Razer Scout as a possible added SATCOM option for special operators. While the device is currently geared for a small footprint on special operations missions, it provides enough power and capability to be used by other military units who need to shrink their gear, but also still want to talk across the globe. And don't worry, for all things shrinking tech and more, we'll keep an eye out. For Military Times, this is Todd South.